Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss class 8, second chapter, MS Excel 2010 function and charts. In the previous class, we have already discussed an introduction of MS Excel. So first we need to know a quick recap of your previous class. What is an MS Excel? MS Excel is in a spreadsheet which is used to do a large amount of mathematical calculation. Microsoft Excel provides inbuilt features and tools such as formulas, functions and data analysis tools that makes easier to work with large amount of data. In this chapter, we have to discuss about the different type of charts and their function. First, we need to know what is this particular box is called cell. Cell is the intersection of column and rows. If we will click here, the address of this cell we can say here. It is the address A3. If we will click here, this cell's name is D6. Now we will start ranges in MS Excel. A cell is a single element in a worksheet. If we are clicking anywhere, this is the single element which is called cell. That can hold a value, some text or formula. We can write anything, any value. It holds some value, text and formula. A cell identifies by its address. Address is given here, N18, which consists of its column letter and row number. Column letter, and this is the column letter and row number. Example, cell B1 is the cell in the second column. If we will place our cursor here, this is the B1. B1 is the cell in the second column and first row. Hope you understand the concept of cell, cell address. A cell is the intersections of rows and columns. Now we will check how to use different type of formula. I have already mentioned some name, marks. Now here we will use math functions. How to calculate? There is a two method. I have discussed the easiest method in the previous class. If I want to calculate this one, to use a formula, first we use a sign which is equal to sign. If we are writing equal to, means now we are going to use formula. Equals to E4 shift plus second one, then again plus, then third one, and press enter key. It is given the sum of math, physics and Hindi. Now no need to write formula again and again. When just keep your cursor in the edge of the cell, when this plus sign will change like this, just drag it, left click and drag it up to where you want to drag. Now it will give all the sum of math, physics, Hindi of all the students. Hope you can now understand. Second method, how to use the formula. Keep your cursor here. Now go to the home. Here you can see auto sum. Press here. Sum is here. If you want to calculate anything else like average count, now we will check how to do all these things. Keep here sum. The selected cell is given here. If you want to this cell sum, then press enter. Easily we can find and just drag it. Now you got. If I want a maximum of this number, which one is the maximum among this number? Go to the auto sum, click on the maximum, ranges is selected, press enter. The maximum number is 222. Like this you can use the different type of feature. If I want to count this one, key, how many numbers are there, just go and count number, sorry, go there, count number, it is selected, press enter key, it is a 14 numbers. If you will count 1, 2, 3, it will be 14. Now, how to select the ranges? How to select? If I want to say, there's a two method. First, with the help of mouse, you can select the ranges. Click here, this plus sign, not this plus sign. This plus sign will come, just drag it and as much as you want to select, while pressing the mouse button, you can select. Like this, you can select as much as you want. But you have to press the left mouse button. And wherever you want to release, just release it. It will select. Second method, if you want to select, you click here, press the shift button and there's a four arrow key, left, right, up and down. Wherever you want to press, you just press it and it will select. If you, by mistake you have selected more, then just press the up button and then you can reduce, you can increase. If left side you want, if right side you want, you can like this select it and just release it. Hope it is a clear to selecting the ranges of cell. First method is with the help of mouse you can select, just click left click and drag it. Second is use the shift key and just use four arrow keys, which is left, right, bottom and up. Mathematical function you can also use. Here is the option is given, auto sum. If you want to calculate these number, the total of these number, then what you have to do, just press here, go to the auto sum, click the sum. Ranges is given. If you don't want this 7, 6, just change the number here. Either you can change here also, E16 not, you want up to E14, you want this much only, then press enter. It is given the total of these number. Hope now you can understand how to perform mathematical calculation. These mathematical calculation we have discussed in the 7th class also. You have done practical also for this. If you want to fill the colors, different type of font color directly here, from here you can fill. If you want to increase the font size, first you have to select it, then after you have, you can perform any type of task. If you want to fill the background color, you can easily do. If you want to merge any cell, just this number of area you want as a single cell, then click on the merge, it will merge like this. Now filter, sort and filter. If I want to filter something, then how to do filter? Click here and click on the filter. See, this logo will come. Now we can change the different type. If I want to arrange this one from Z to A, alphanumeric number we want to arrange Z to A. See, change S, R, P, it is arranged from Z to A. Here I want to arrange from largest to smallest, then again it is changed. Like this you can use the different. If you want to hide any number in the name, if you want to hide someone's name, that Arav, Aman and Gyan, I want to hide it, then press OK. See, it is now hidden. So this type of filter you can use. If you want to delete anything, select and press the delete button, it will delete. Last is how to change the seat. If I want to, by default there's a three seat available, three work seat is available. If you want to increase, you can increase as much as you want. If you want to delete anyone, then press the and delete, then again right click and delete. If you want to rename, just double click here, backspace and write any name that you want. Again, if you want to delete or rename, then rename it. Like this, you can do the different type of mathematical functions. if you want to do any, if you want to find average, sum, subtraction, you want to find maximum, minimum, you can use. You can edit the sheet also by renaming it, deleting it. You can use the filter to hide and unhide anything. So this is for today. In the next class, we will discuss cell reference and charts in MS Excel. Now, your homework is to practice all these functions in your home, and then after we will discuss the further topic. Thank you.